الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، ثم الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين، حبيب إله العالمين بالقاسم المصطفى محمد وعلى آل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد وعجل فرجهم. Dear brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. All honor is mine to be able to be amongst you for another episode discussing the holy verses of Quran and the narrations of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by the blessing of the verses of the Holy Quran and the narrations of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam and the shrines of Imam Hussein alayhi as-salam and Abu al-Fadl Abbas alayhi as-salam to bless us to be amongst the followers of the Holy Quran and the narrations of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. If you remember and you are following our series, we started talking about the characteristics of hypocrites. And we mentioned a couple of verses within Surah Al-Baqarah chapter 2. We will continue chapter 2 verse 14 and 15 inshallah in this episode, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he talks about the hypocrites, he says, وَإِذَا لَقُوا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قَالُوا آمَنَّا وَإِذَا خَلَوْا إِلَىٰ شَيَاطِينِهِمْ قَالُوا إِنَّا مَعَكُمْ إِنَّمَا نَحْنُ مُسْتَهْزِئُونَ. Allah says, when they meet the faithful, they say, we believe, but when they are alone, they're devils, they say, we are with you. We are only mocking or deriding them. See, very, very important. These hypocrites have two faces. When they meet the faithful, they say, we believe. But when they are alone with their devils, people like themselves, other hypocrites, they say, we are with you. We were only mocking or deriding the believers. If you remember, within the previous episode, we talked about some more characteristics of the hypocrites within the ahadith and the narrations of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. We mentioned a couple of them and we drew a beautiful conclusion, an action plan from those narrations. I brought three more or four more narrations from the lives of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam, which specifically tell us what are the characteristics of the believers and the characteristics of the hypocrites, in addition to those characteristics that we talked about. In Tuhaf al-Uqul, Kitab Tuhaf al-Uqul, page 397. Let me just pause here before reading this verse. It is very, very important. If we haven't downloaded the book, Tuhaf al-Uqul, it is in English. It's been translated in a very beautiful translation. It has narrations from the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, now Imam Ali alayhi salam, all the way to the beloved Imam Mahdi ajalallahu ta'ala farajahu sharif. Each Imam, beautiful narrations have been compiled in this book. It is very, very important that we, I'm reminding myself and you brothers and sisters about the action plans that we gave in the first or second or third episode that we talked about, in addition to reading the verses of the Holy Quran on a daily basis, which should be minimum 50 verses of the Holy Quran. We put this book of narrations of Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam next to the Quran, because we remind ourselves, Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi stated in the last sermon that he gave, in Sermon of Ghadir, that he says, إِنِّي تَارَكُمْ فِيكُمُ الثَّقْلَيْنِ كِتَابَ اللَّهُ وَعِتْرَتِي أَهْلِ بَيْتِي مَا إِن تَمَسَّكْتُمْ بِهِمَا لَن تَضِلُّوا بَعْدِي أَبَدًا. The Rasulullah mentions that I'm leaving you with two valuable things, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and my progeny. If you hold on to them both, you will not astray. So we read Quran, we ponder, and these series that we're talking about is about informing us, educating us, myself first before you brothers and sisters, to understand the verses of the Holy Quran more, and then next to it, the ahadith of Ahlul Bayt. So every day one hadith and the 50 verse of the Holy Quran. We see at the end of the year how many more ahadith we know and how much these ahadith have helped us in reshaping our personality and characteristics and demeanor, and how much that reshape benefited us, how much we were able to enhance our personality and grow and develop our personality. So it's very important. So action plan will be, before I give the action plan from the narration, that we make sure we download the book Tuhaf al-Uqul. If you don't have it, you can either email us to the email of the TV channel, or Mustafa you can email me personally or the channel, inshallah, and we will send you the link. The hadith says about the characteristics of the believer and the hypocrite. Al-mu'minu qalilul kalami kathirul amal. The believer is the one who speaks less, who talks less, but works more. Beautiful narration. What a guideline it sets to see, to evaluate myself. They're giving us this evaluation form. These ahadith gives us evaluation form. We put it next to our personality, next to our characteristics. Mustafa, do you talk more and work less? Or do you talk less and more work? Al-mu'minu, qalilu al-kalam, kathiru al-amal. Wal-munafiqu, kathiru al-kalam, qalilu al-amal. It's the opposite. The believer talks less, acts more. But the hypocrite talks more, kathiru al-kalam, qalilu al-amal, but he works little. So that becomes a very good criteria for me to keep in mind. Do I sit within the within the gathering of the believers according to the Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam, according to the narrations of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam, or am I part of the hypocrites? It's very, very important. These are very, very small little detailed action items for you and I to reshape our personality and characteristics. The action plan will be, if I want to do something, I have a new initiative that I want to act upon it, qurbatan Allah Ta'ala, let me start. Rather than just sitting next to people, I want to do this, and if we're able to do this, I want to do this, and this, and this, and this, and never have in mind to take an action. So believer is the one who talks less and acts more, and the hypocrite who's the one who talks more and acts less. What creates more hypocrisy within us? So we talked about some of the characteristics of the hypocrite. That, for example, in here that he talks more and he acts less. But what is the origin of this hypocrisy? One of the origin of hypocrisy. What initiates hypocrisy within us? What empowers this notion of hypocrisy within us? It's from the beautiful hadith by Imam Sadiq alayhi salam, where Imam says, قال أبا عبد الله عليه السلام الغناء يورث النفاق ويعقب الفقر. غناء, music, which more than 99% of our maraja, our scholars, have forbidden listening to any kind of music. Haram, any kind of music, any sound that is produced by musical instrument. And I don't want to get into the discussion of the fiqh and the reason behind it, but we call it music. Al-ghina'u, music, yurithu an-nifaq. It empowers nifaq and hypocrisy in our heart. وَيُعْقِبُ الْفَقْرِ, and it will continue to bring poverty for that person. We talked about hypocrites from the verse of the Holy Quran and its characteristics. We brought examples from the narrations of Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam about what characteristics do hypocrites possess. Right now we're talking about what originates, what initiates, what motivates hypocrisy within us. So the action plan will be, if I know, alhamdulillah, we don't, but in here and there maybe, we might be tended toward listening to music. From now it will be no, because I don't want to be amongst the hypocrites. I want to be amongst the believers. Another beautiful hadith, which is also in the Kitab Tuhaful Uqul, page 212. This is a very, very important book for us to download and read. Qala alayhi salam, Imam narrates, إِنَّ الْمُؤْمِنَ إِذَا نَظَرَ اِعْتَبَرَ وَإِذَا سَكَتَ تَفَكَّرَ وَإِذَا تَكَلَّمَ ذَكَرَ. Beautiful narration. Imam says, Imam Ali alayhi salam, the commander of the faithful, that we claim that we are his follower, that he is our wali, he is our master, he is our imam, he is the vicegerent to the holy prophet, he is the khalifatullah on earth. Imam says, the true believer is what who learns lessons from what he sees. The true believer is that who learns lessons from what he sees. Anything that I believe we discussed it in a previous episode, long time ago, Everywhere that he looks, he tries to learn something from his surrounding. He tries to learn from others' behavior. They asked one of the companions of the Holy Prophet, where did you learn your morality and your characteristics? He said, I learned my morality and characteristics from a person who is immoral, from the person who acts wrongly, who commits sin. They told him, how? He said, when I saw him committing sin, I learned that I should not commit this sin. How disgraceful is this action? I should not be committing it. I saw a person lying, and I saw how other people hate this person lying. I started realizing that I should not lie. People gossiping, other people do not like a person who gossips. What I learned from this person who is acting wrong, I learned to act on the opposite. So, إذا نظر اعتبر. When he sees anything that he sees, when he has his eyesight on something, he learns from it. وَإِذَا سَكَتَ تَفَكَّرَ. And when he's silent, he is. وَإِذَا سَكَتَ تَفَكَّرَ. And when he's silent, he's thinking. So when he sees, he's taking lessons. اعتبر. He takes lessons. When he's quiet, he's thinking. وَإِذَا تَكَلَّمَ ذَكَرَ. And when he mentions something, when the words that he utters, he mentions God when he speaks. Doesn't mean that we just have to say Alhamdulillah, Subhanallah, MashaAllah. No. Everything that he says, he remembers Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala in every word that he utters. Another action plan. Three of them within this one hadith. So number one, when we look around, we make sure to try to learn lesson, any lesson that we can learn from our surrounding, from people's action, from people's behavior. We learn action. We don't talk about them. We learn. We see something happen. We learn. We read something. How this information can benefit me to get me closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That should be our main objective of seeing things. Not seeing things for no other, just for the sake of seeing. No. Even though, for example, we go to a vacation. We go to a beautiful beach or jungles and trees. We see and we call it Subhanallah. We mention Alhamdulillah. What is this beautiful creation of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala? How much we are indebted to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala that we are thankful and to use His blessings in the right way. And when we, so that's number one. Whatever we see, we learn a lesson. Number two, when we silence, we are thinking. How can I improve myself? How can I get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Ahl al-Bayt alayhim salam? That should be always occupying our mind. Third, anything that we utter, anything that comes out of our mouth and tongue, it should be the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And keep repeating and repeating and repeating all the time, not forgetting that we are responsible for every word that we utter. It's a lengthy hadith. I'm just picking some part of it, inshallah. You'll be able to download the book and read it. It's beautiful. It gives more characteristics of the believer and then many characteristics of this believer. I just have picked a couple, two or three characteristics. وَالْمُنَافِقُ إِذَا نَظَرَ لَهَا. Hypocrite, hypocrite, on the other hand, is that who plays when he sees. He takes everything for granted. He doesn't learn any lesson from what he sees. Anything that happens to him and he gets to see it, he doesn't pay attention to it. And وَإِذَا سَكَتَ سَهَا. While he's quiet, he omits when he is silent. And he talks nonsense when he speaks. And again, there are more characteristics. So I have downloaded this book. Every day, I read one hadith. I get to this hadith. It gives me a guideline. It draws the map for me. This is the map to be a believer, to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Ahl al-Bayt alayhim salam. And this is the map for the hypocrites. These are what hypocrites do. This is the personality of the hypocrite. Any intellectual person will pick the believer. We all want to be a believer. We want to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But some of us, we lose the map. Some of us, we don't have the guideline. Some of us, we have taken the wrong exit. Well, the map brings us back. This is the right way. This is the right path of Muhammad and Al Muhammad. So another one of them, actually, let me mention before finishing this episode. إِذَا اسْتَغْنَى شَكَرَ. A believer, when he has, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he thanks God when he is rich and becomes patient when a trouble befalls him. Believer, he is near to satisfaction and far from discontent. Believer, he is pleased with the few gifts of God and does not show frustration for the many troubles. His good intentions are too many to be applied. He intends a lot of good but can do only a part of them and sigh for the good deeds that he missed. On the believer, he exceeds the bounds when he is rich and wails when a misfortune befalls him. He is near discontent and far from satisfaction. He is displeased when he receives few gifts from God and is not satisfied when that much more gifts he gets. He intends many evil doings, but he can do only a part of them and sighs for the ill deeds that he missed. What a beautiful hadith. What a guideline from every aspect of it. It has, the Imam has drawn us a map for us to be a believer and be far, far, far away from a disbeliever. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us to be able to apply these teachings from the teachings of the Holy Quran and Muhammad and Ali Muhammad. And we will conclude with the most important dua, and that is asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to hasten the reappearance of our beloved Imam, Imam Mahdi ajalallahu ta'ala farajahu sharif. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. اللهم كن لوليك الحجة ابن الحسن صلواتك عليه وعلى آبائه في هذه الساعة وفي كل ساعة وليا وحافظا وقائدا وناصرا ودليلا وعينا حتى تسكن وردك طوعا وتمتعه فيها طويلا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين